So I've been using the Asus ZenBook 14 as my primary laptop for around 2 months now. Because I was looking for a budget Ultrabook at that time, this one seemed like a perfect blend of power and portability, so I picked one up for myself. And its Ryzen 4000 series CPU convinced me even further to ditch the idea of getting the XPS 13 for now, which costs almost as double as the ZenBook 14 here in Nepal. My unit is equipped with the Hexa-Core Ryzen 4500 CPU, integrated Radeon graphics, 8GB of RAM, 512GB of SSD, and a 250 nits display. All this for around 1.1 lakh Nepali rupees is a pretty sweet deal in this part of the world. But in the US, it gets even better with a dedicated NVIDIA MX350 GPU at around $650. Anyway, after using this laptop for around 2 months now, what I can say without a doubt is that the ZenBook 14 is currently the best value notebook available in the market. With its surprisingly premium build quality, what Asus has managed to achieve with this laptop is truly remarkable. Unlike the Asus Swift 3 that I reviewed a while back, the Asus ZenBook 14 feels and looks a heck of a lot more compelling. It has an all-metal build and weighs just 1.22 kilograms, so carrying it on my backpack is a great relief for my back and is appreciable to anyone who is constantly on the run. The lid has this classic spun metal finish, and yes, you can open it with just one hand too. There's also no flex on the lid, but unfortunately, it does pick up fingerprints and smudges rather easily. It cannot tilt flat 180 degrees, but that's fine by me, and like with other ZenBook laptops that we've seen in the past, this one too comes with an Argo Lift hinge design. This allows for number one, a better typing experience, and number two, an efficient cooling mechanism by providing the air vents at the bottom, so more room to breathe. Similarly, the four rubber feet provide a fairly solid grip and do not let the laptop slide off that easily. The two speaker grills can be found on either side, and because of the way they're positioned, they don't get blocked or muffled while placing it on a flat surface or on your lap. This stereo speaker system is also certified by Harman Kardon. Simply put, I really like this audio setup. The audio can get plenty loud and there's even a hint of bass. The treble is not that enjoyable though, and the sound gets muffled when listening to it at higher volumes, but still, this speaker can fare you well. Now getting to the ports, Asus has proudly ditched the 3.5mm headphone jack, which I find really weird, and there is no Ethernet port as well. But as a consolation, the company ships USB-C adapters for both inside the box. Regardless of that, you will find a standard HDMI 2.0 and two USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C ports on the left. You can charge the laptop using either of these USB-C connections. On the right, there's a USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A and a micro SD card reader. The USB Type-A port here feels like a blessing considering how manufacturers are going all out with only USB Type-C ports in thin and light machines. Still, I find it weird that Asus has gone for a micro SD card slot instead of a regular one, which would have been my ideal choice. All in all, the ZenBook 14 is an incredibly well-built notebook, which raises the bar for how good a budget laptop should be. It is sturdy, it is thin and lightweight, and therefore gets top points for portability. Coming to the display, the ZenBook 14 has a 14 inches anti-glare FHD IPS panel. Thanks to the slim bezels, Asus has managed to pack in a 14-inch screen on such a small footprint, making this laptop one of the world's thinnest devices of its kind. Likewise, there are two configurations for the display, the one with 250 nits brightness and the other one that has 400 nits brightness. The one I have has 250 nits of brightness, but I would highly recommend you get the 400 nits variant if available. Because the thing is, besides higher brightness itself, this configuration also uses a power efficient 1W display contrary to the 2.5W display on the 250 nits one. Other than this, both options have the same 100% sRGB color gamut. Talking about brightness, I am someone who mostly uses the laptop indoors, so 250 nits fared just fine for me, but when taking it outdoors on a bright sunny day, visibility does take a big hit. The viewing angles are quite good and its anti-reflective properties make it easier to use it in a well-lit room, distraction-free. I did notice a dismissible level of backlight bleed on the bottom right corner of the display, but that's visible only when viewing an entirely pitch black content. Now, the color accuracy part of this display is where it gets really interesting. In its factory settings, the color levels look absolutely ridiculous. Everything looked abnormal with a high contrast pastel effect to them, and especially the human subjects came off very smooth and almost cartoonish. But I am happy to say that after a bunch of driver updates and playing around with the default color calibration settings for some time, the color quality of the panel now looks pretty good. Still, I would hesitate to recommend this laptop to someone who's into professional photo editing and stuff. Having said that, it is more than fine for regular usage like content consumption, web browsing, or even light editing tasks. It is sharp enough for you to notice any sort of pixelation, and the colors are adequately punchy as well. Moving on, the ZenBook 14 has an edge-to-edge keyboard. The chiclet-style keys are well-spaced, and with a 1.4mm key travel, they are not that noisy or mushy. Therefore, I had an enjoyable typing experience on this machine. The keyboard is also backlit, and you can choose from 3 levels of brightness. They light up quite nice, and I had no problem operating the keyboard in a dark room. As for the trackpad, while many other manufacturers stick with plastic trackpads on a device of this price range, Asus has gone with a glass trackpad. It has integrated left and right keys, both of which click very well enough. Overall, the trackpad is smooth and feels really nice to use. It supports Windows Precision drivers as well, and thus can trigger Windows gestures with no hiccup. Additionally, the trackpad also doubles up as a number pad by long pressing this icon right here. Alright, now it's time to talk about its performance. Like I said earlier, my unit comes with the AMD Ryzen 4500 CPU and Radeon integrated graphics. It is also available in a faster Ryzen 7 4700U configuration or with the entry-level MX350 dedicated GPU. In terms of memory, you can choose between either 8GB or 16GB of LPDDR4X RAM, but you'll need to be very careful while making this decision because the RAM here is shouldered to the motherboard and you cannot upgrade it later on. However, you can upgrade the SSD if you want. Here, my unit comes with 8GB of dual channel memory at 3733MHz and 512GB of M.2 NVMe PCIe 3.0 SSD. Unfortunately, the sequential read and write speed of the onboard SSD is not that great for an NVMe SSD. Still, app installation and opening time is fast enough, and usually the laptop boots up in 15 seconds or less. For light to medium usage, this laptop can handle everything you throw at it. Simultaneously browsing the web with a couple of tabs, editing Word documents, and using Photoshop is a breeze for this Renault-powered laptop. Under this, the ZenBook 14 does not heat up either, averaging at around 34 degrees CPU temperature. Because of its compact size, the ZenBook 14 only has a single heat pipe and a single fan setup, which is not the most effective cooling system. But again, this laptop is not meant for heavy users anyway. The integrated Radeon graphics on this one is impressive in itself, easily outperforming the competing GPU on Intel processors, but that does not mean that this laptop can run AAA titles, although it can run esports titles and other light games well enough. I tried CSGO and FIFA 2021 on it and got fairly respectable FPS. Under medium settings, I got acceptable 55 to 60 FPS in CSGO. Similarly, FIFA 2021 is playable in medium settings at 30 to 35 FPS. However, continuous gaming on the ZenBook 14 can be an issue though because things here can get really hot really fast. Moving on, the My Asus app is pretty useful as well. You can change different settings, perform diagnostics, download latest drivers, etc. Interestingly, I faced an issue with Wi-Fi auto connection even though this laptop has the stellar Intel Wi-Fi 6 AX200 card. Later, that issue was solved by downloading the appropriate drivers from the web. Now, another great thing on the Asus ZenBook 14 is its 67Wh battery. Asus claims up to 22 hours of backup on the 400 nits display variant. However, on my 250 nits unit, I consistently got around 8 to 9 hours of battery backup. I would normally keep the brightness at about 40 to 50% and battery set to best performance with Whisper fan mode turned on. And you know, my usage mostly consisted of editing Word documents, browsing the web with multiple tabs open, and light Photoshop editing every now and then. Besides the impressive battery mileage, charging the laptop is quite fast too. It can go from 0 to 100% in about 1 hour and 50 minutes. The 65W charger is lightweight and comfortable to carry around too. And you can also use any Power Delivery certified 65W fast charger to charge the ZenBook 14 as well. So what's left? Yes, the webcam. And like with every other laptops, this one too comes with a 720p webcam. It's not mind-blowingly good, but it's better than other laptops that you get in this price range. The overall image quality is looking a bit soft, but I think it's passable for your regular video calling needs, and the audio from the microphone array is good enough too. For security, this laptop does not have a fingerprint sensor, but the IR sensor-enabled Windows Hello unlocks this device incredibly fast. So wrapping it all up, like I said in the intro, the Asus ZenBook 14 is a beast of a notebook. There is zero doubts on that. Its Ryzen variant easily outperforms its Intel counterpart, even though the latter costs slightly more in most of the regions. So if you are a casual user who seeks portability and enough power, this can be an excellent choice. The exclusion of the headphone jack might be a deal breaker for many, but if you are someone who can look past that, its sheer performance, its premium build, decent display, and excellent battery life, and with all the other quirks, this machine can easily sway you away. So that was all for our review of the Asus ZenBook 14. What do you think about this laptop? Do let us know in the comments below. Till then, I'm Pratima Adhikari, and I'll see you in the next one.